Hi, I'm Michelle Gordon, and welcome to Ask Amethyst. I've had a question from a beautiful earth angel called Yelena, and she would like to know, just ask the question, where should she go next and what should she do? So it's a pretty broad question, so I'd be interested to see what Amethyst has to say. And we'll just give the cards a little bit of a shuffle. I think we need to pick up four cards. And let's see. One, two, three, and four. Next up. So, protection. As an earth angel, you can be quite sensitive to the energy surrounding you. Protect yourself from negative energies by visualizing a pink bubble of light around you. You can also ask the angels to protect you and surround you with light. So no matter where you go or what you do next, Yelena, protect yourself. Make sure that you take care of your energies and you keep out any negative energies as you make choices to move forward with new things. So, I mean, you can use the bubble of light. A lot of people find that the easiest way to protect themselves, but definitely go with what kind of earth angel you are for the form of protection that you use. So, you know, as an angel, you could use angelic protection. As a fairy, you could use elemental protection, so there's all different ways that you can use to protect yourself from negative energies. So figure out which way is best for you and do it on a daily basis. Help. The angels exist to help you, but they cannot do so without your permission, so please ask them. It doesn't matter how big or how small your request is, they're always more than happy to help. So have you asked the angels for help with where you should go next and what you should do? If not, ask them. They're just sitting there, flying around, hovering around, waiting for you to ask them for help. So definitely reach out to your angels and ask them, what should I do next? Where should I go? Innocence. When life is approached from an innocent viewpoint, things are seen as they really are rather than what we assume them to be based on our past experiences. Living in the present moment without any previous judgments clouding it is the most blissful way to live. Try a little innocence today. So what Amethyst is saying there is that you need to look at your current life situation in the most innocent way possible. So look at it as it actually is, not how you think it is based on your past. And also when new situations come up or when you make new choices, try to make those choices based on what the actual situation is, what the actual truth is, rather than based on all your past experiences. Try not to bring your past into your future, basically. And balance. Balance is so important. It is needed in every aspect of life. Work and play, fun and seriousness, light and dark. When things get out of balance, our health and relationships can suffer. So make it a priority to gain balance in every aspect of your life. So perhaps the next step that you need to be taking is to find more balance in your life. So balance between working and relaxing, between family and loved ones and your own time. So it's finding that balance in life that is actually going to be helpful in your next step. So I hope that was of some help to you. And thank you for asking the question. Thank you for joining us this morning for the hangout on Twin Flames, which was really good fun with Sarah Vine. So you can check that out on YouTube as well if you want to. But if you're watching this video and you would like to ask a question of Amethyst, Velvet, who's an old soul, or Aria, who is a fairy, then please just get in touch either through Facebook or you can email me and I'll put the email at the end of this video. So thank you for joining me and hope to see you again soon. Bye!